once was a man that loved to drink palm wine. He drank it all day. He could drink 50 calabash gourds a day. And he had his favorite palm wine maker that made the best palm wine of all the land. And he loved his palm wine maker because he made the best palm wine. Now one day, when the palm wine maker was working hard to make the drink, he fell from the tree that he was climbing. And he had a terrible accident and died. And when he died, he went to another place, the place between life and death. And as he fell. And the palm wine drinker was like, this is terrible, this is not good. I have to bring my palm wine maker back. I know there's a place in between the two worlds that if I can find him then, before he goes to the other side, I can bring him back to life. And I know there's a man in a village not too far from here that knows exactly where that place is. I'm going to find him. And the old man said to him, yes, I know this place is where your palm wine drinker has gone. But you need to help me if I'm going to help you. What can I do for you? My daughter left many days ago to go to the market. Yes. And she disappeared. All I know is that she followed some man that walked through the village. And that's all I know. I will bring her back to you so you can help me. And so the story begins with the young woman. She had gone to the market 4 days a week to bring her wares. She brought fish and vegetables, potatoes and melons. She brought nuts and beautiful material to sell. And everyone came to the market every day. People would come back and forth. And she sat and waited to sell her goods. One day, this man came through the village and walked through the market, and she had never seen him before. She thought, wow, look at him. Look how tall he is. And look at his clothes. And he's not too thin. He's not too fat. He's a nice-looking man. I wonder who he is. And the man walked through the market looking at everything. And everyone was looking at him because he was so unique. And she thought, I want to follow him and see where he lives. He must have a nice house. Do you see his clothes? So she followed after him. She just left all her wares just laying there. She would never do that. But she thought he was the complete gentleman and that he was going to go to a nice place to live. And as he walked, she followed behind him, watching every move that he made. Look at him. Look how he moves. Excuse me, where do you live? I want to know where you live. I've never seen you before.
Where I live, he said, is a dark place. I live many miles from here, but you don't want to follow me.
Yes, I do. I want to see where you live.
I live many miles away. Do not follow me.
No, but I want to know where you live, and I'm just wondering about you.
So they walked across the desert. They walked and they walked, and he said, we're going to come upon many...
Oh, what's that? A fish on a bicycle?
I was going to say, we're going to come to many strange creatures at the edge of the forest. And the edge of the forest, there are many strange creatures. Da-ding.
And as they got closer, she started hearing sounds that she had never heard before. And the complete gentleman said to her, now that I've reached the edge of the forest, this is your last chance to turn back. Because when we go inside, we're going to meet many curious creatures. And you might not like it. This is your last chance to turn around and go back home.
No. I want to know where you live. I've gone this far already, and I'm sure you have a beautiful house.
Well, I warned you, the bush is thick and dark. And there are many creatures we are going to come upon. You're going to be scared.
No, I won't be scared. Please wait for me.
Whoa!
That fish on the bicycle almost hit me. That's crazy. There are many strange creatures here. Please wait for me. Wait for me.
And she followed after him. When they came to the deepest, darkest part of the forest, he said, this is the endless forest. And we're going to meet many strange creatures now. I am sorry that you've had to come this far, and now you're going to be very scared, I think.
No, I won't be scared. Just I want to see where you live, she said.
And as he met the strange creatures, they came and started taking back his body parts, for everything was borrowed from them.
Thank you very much.
Yes, yes, I'll come and get the arm tomorrow.
Another creature came out.
Ah, did you see that? His arm is gone.
And then another creature came and took his other arm.
Hey, I'll see you tomorrow, yes?
Yes, thank you very much, he said.
And slowly, the complete gentleman started coming apart before her eyes.
Yes, I am taking it back. I'll see you tomorrow, right, my friend?
Yes, yes. Yes, I'll see you tomorrow.
Another creature came from another direction, and she came running out going,
No, no, don't take that leg. He won't have a leg to stand on.
No, that is true. Yes, it's my leg, and he'll come and get it tomorrow.
What? I don't believe this. The man I thought was so complete is coming apart before my eyes. This is terrible.
And another strange creature came and took his torso.
Hey, do you spill some mango juice on this?
I'm sorry that I did that.
Gotta take care of this now. Give it back to me.
What? He just took your torso. First your arms and your legs and now your torso, and all that's left is your head. But you still have a beautiful face. Oh, this is not good. My complete gentleman has totally come apart before my eyes.
Yes. I told you we were going to meet many strange creatures. And it's not over yet.
What? Where are you going? Are you going to your house?
Yes. But I have to meet somebody else before we get there.
Oh, this is not good. This makes me very nervous. My complete gentleman is now just a head. This is not good.
You haven't seen the worst of it. For now, you're going to see something else disappear.
What? What else could disappear?
And out of the sky came a stranger creature. He had a funny sound, and the complete gentleman, who is now just a head, said,
I'm sorry that you have to see this, but this is how it goes.
What? What? What's happening?
And off came his face, and there was a skull.
What? Oh my gosh. My complete gentleman is now just a skull, and he's rolling away from me.
And it made the most terrible sound as it rolled away. She thought,
what am I going to do? What am I going to do? Now I'm in this forest and I'm totally lost. And now what I thought was a complete gentleman has totally come apart. And now he's just a skull. What do I do? Maybe I should go back. Come back. What do I do?
And the skull rolled until it came to an edge of a hole. And he just fell right in. He said,
la, 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 la. Now you came to my house. This is where I live, in this hole. Yes, here.
And when she came nearer, he dropped in.
Yes, this is where I live, she said, glunk.
What? What, this is where you live?
Yes, you came all this way. It's true, I live in a hole. And now this is a place for you to stay too, because I'm going to trap you. You have to stay with me and my family. You will be here for a long time.
And then he ran off and got a cowrie shell from off the wall. And he pulled it off and he put it around her neck. And he said, for as long as this cowrie shell is around your neck, you shall never speak again. And he put it around her neck and she never spoke again. And he gave her a frog to sit on. And she had to live in the hole for a long time. And she was so sad. The skull rolled up and said,
I told you shouldn't have followed me this far. All those body parts were borrowed. And now you have to live here with me and my family. Yes, yes, cry as much as you want. But that's how it is. You shouldn't have followed me so far.
And she was very, very sad.
So that is the story that was told to you?
Yes. That is what I know.
So I shall go back to the market and find what happened to her. Because that's where it all began.
Yes, that's very wise.
Yes, yes, I will go to the market and I will find the complete gentleman.
And when he came walking through, the palm wine drinker was very, very well known in the market for his magical spells that he would make and concoctions that would help people. And he saw the complete gentleman walking through and he thought,
ah, that must be him. I would follow him too. He is so good looking and look at his clothes. I can understand why she followed after him. Now I will follow after him and see where he goes. He will lead me to her.
And so he followed him across the desert. And when the complete gentleman came to the edge of the forest, he walked right in into the deep dark of the bush. And the palm wine drinker followed after him, but he knew that he had to conceal himself, so he had a special spell that would turn him into a lizard.
Ah, that is exactly where he went. I shall do my spell now and follow him as a lizard. He will never notice me.
And so he turned into a lizard and followed the complete gentleman into the forest. And he watched such strange things happen, because as the complete gentleman walked through the forest, strange creatures from all sides came and took away parts of his body.
Thank you very much. Thank you. Thank you.
It was the weirdest thing to ever be seen.
Yeah, I'll see you tomorrow.
The complete gentleman again was coming apart before his eyes.
Yeah, tomorrow.
See you later.
Hey, I'll see you tomorrow.
Yes, thank you.
Until he was just a head laying on the ground, for everything was taken away except for his head. And then a strange creature came and took away his face until he was just a skull.
The lizard couldn't believe it. The palm wine drinker was like, I cannot believe this. The complete gentleman is a fraud.
And so he came up to the hole where the young woman was crying. He crawled up very quietly. He said,
You. You are obviously the one that got taken by the perfect gentleman. I am here to come take you away. Here, take my hand. We can run away from here. Why can't you speak? Do you hear what I'm saying?
She reached out her hand.
He said, yes, come on, before they see us.
And he pulled her out of the hole.
Come, quietly.
But with the cowrie shell around her neck,
a strange sound came out. It was something they had never heard before. That skulls come running out, going, bring her back.
And the palm wine drinker and the woman panicked. They started seeing skulls running after them.
They're like, let's get out of here, quick.
Skulls came from all sides, going,
bring her back.
And they tried to put a cowrie shell around his neck too, but
they ran fast. Let's get away from here, quick.
And the skulls come running after them. Thunderous sounds like empty petrol drums rolling, ba-doom, ba-doom, ba-doom.
Bring her back, they said.
Bring her back!
So I turned her into a kitten with a magical spell, and I slipped her into my coat, and I turned into what you would call a sparrow and flew off back to the village where her father lived. When the father saw her, he was so happy.
Oh, my daughter!
And she gave him loving touches, and she was like, couldn't say a word. He's like, what's wrong? What's your voice?
What happened to my daughter's voice? She cannot speak.
And the palm wine drinker came up and said, "There was a carousel around her neck that took away her voice. A strange skull family had her captured, and I took her and we ran away. Oh, but what good is my daughter without a voice? You must bring her back. Bring her voice back. Somehow you have to bring her voice back. And then you can marry her, because I think she likes you."
"Yes, I like her very much too."
"Okay, I will find out how to take the spell off of her. I know I can do it. And then we will come back and you'll help me find my palm wine maker."
"Yes, now I must follow him. He must have some magical spells himself,"
the palm wine drinker said. "I will go back to the market and I will follow him and see where he's going. Maybe he will show me something that I don't know." And the complete gentleman came back to the village again. And the palm wine drinker saw him from afar,
thought, "Ah, there he is again. Wow, look at him. Look how he walks. Look at his clothes. He is so beautiful. Why couldn't I look like him? Ah, I am not such a good-looking man."
And he went to the edge of the village and he cried a little bit.
"I am so ugly." But then he thought, "Wait a minute. He is just a skull. I saw him come apart before my eyes."
And so he turned back into a lizard and he followed the complete gentleman. And he saw him pick some leaves off of a tree, and he picked them and let them fall to the ground. And he said, "If this leaf is never eaten by that woman, then she will always be my prisoner as the skull family." And the lizard saw that and said,
"Hey, this is it. This is how I can bring back her voice."
And that's exactly what he did. He brought the leaves back to the village and he cooked a really good soup out of them, and she ate it and her voice came back. And so the old man said, "Yes, and you are forever married." And so that is why, how the palm wine drinker got his wife, and they went to go find the palm wine maker in the other world. And the old man pointed the way to go.
"Yes."
And together they searched for the palm wine maker together. And that is how he had his wife. And the story would go on and on and on. For one day he will find his palm wine maker and bring him back.